Llegamos ya a las 5 y 25 minutos de esta tarde tan especial en la que contamos en los estudios de Vicio Radio con Cristian Smith, quien está ya aquí con nosotros y con quien arrancaremos en breve, en unos minutos, la entrevista. Para toda la gente que quiera escucharnos, ya sabéis, a través de la FM de Vicio Radio. Saludos a la gente de Málaga, Melilla, Murcia, Madrid, Mallorca, toda la gente que se conecta a través de la FM y también a los que nos escucháis a través de la web viciosradio.com o Vicios Magazine. Recordar que además esta entrevista y la sesión, que arrancará a las 6 de la tarde y hasta las 7, la podréis disfrutar en directo a través de video streaming desde el Facebook de Vicios Radio, de Vicios Magazine y también de todo el equipo y todos nosotros, que por supuesto vamos a compartir el link. Así que no os lo perdáis aquí en Vicios Radio, Cristian Smith en unos minutos. Entrevista y set en directo.
Tuesday from 6 till 7 p.m. presented by Rosanna Nunn on Vicious Radio.
Y 33 minutos de esta tarde de martes tan especial como veníamos anunciando desde que hemos arrancado el programa desde hace unos días atrás. Hoy contamos con un gran artista, un experimentado DJ y productor que ha pasado, pues podría decir, sus últimas décadas trabajando sin descanso en la música electrónica. Hablamos además de un artista al que admiro y he admirado hace mucho tiempo, también todo mi círculo de amigos, y que me siento orgullosa de tener aquí, y que nos cuente un poquito más sobre su trayectoria, todas las experiencias que ha vivido, y sobre todo algo muy importante, sobre la presentación de ese nuevo álbum que hace 15 días salía a la venta y que, según me ha contado bajo micro, podremos escuchar un poquito más durante esa sesión que va a realizar desde las 6 hasta las 7 de la tarde. Ahora sí, no me enredo más. Christian Smith, thanks for coming. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me. I'm very happy to be here.
I'm very, very happy for staying here with you today. So, well, let's start today in English. We're going to do a short interview. After that, he's going to play a live set that everyone can share it and follow on Facebook Live.
Oh, yes.
I would like to know more about you because I've been reading a lot on the internet, but, well, you are here and I would like to know more about you. And when did you decide to jump into music?
Well, it started at a very early age. I have an older brother and older sister who used to bring back mixtapes when I was 10 years old.
Whoa, and 10 years old?
I was very young, and I listened to DJs mixing disco and electronic music. Not electronic, I should call it electro and soul. And yeah, I loved those mixtapes, and then I slowly got into music. And then when I was 14, I started DJing as a hobby. And I went to university, and while I was at university, I produced a few records that became very successful with Carl Cox, Jeff Mills. And then suddenly my DJ career started, and within 6 months, I started playing all around the world. And that was around 20 years ago.
Wow. 20 years ago.
Yeah, pretty crazy.
Yeah. So, if you had not been a DJ producer, what would you do now? What do you think that you were working in? Businessman, maybe, because
that's how I started. I mean, I went to university and I studied finance and international business.
Yes, it was. I was surprised about it.
Yeah. And then I was an investment banker for 2 years.
Really?
Yeah, but I hated it. I mean, like, you know, the money was good, of course, but everything else was horrible. I was not a happy person. And the only way out of that profession, I thought, was more university. So I went back to university to get a master's degree in economics. And while I was at university, I produced those tracks that became big hits and gave me an international career as a DJ.
Yeah, but at first you studied because you wanted, or was your family that introduced to doing this, and then you realized that you were not going to be happy then?
Well, to be honest, when I was younger, I always loved DJing, I loved clubbing. But back then, it was not really a big profession, being a professional DJ. It's very, very few people traveled back in those days. So, yeah, so I did the normal thing. You know, what most people do is get education. And it gives you also, you know, getting an education gives you also more time to think about what you really want to do in life.
Okay. Seguimos con la entrevista para toda la gente que se incorpora ahora mismo. Estamos con Christian Smith aquí en Viciu Radio, quien realizará además una sesión en directo desde las 6 hasta las 7. Christian, tell us about your new album that you published 15 days ago, I think, no?
Yes, it's an album called Synergy. And the name Synergy is because every track on the album is a collaboration that I made with good friends of mine while I was touring around the world in the last year. And it's all about teamwork and working together and achieving goals together. So I produced tracks together with long-time friend John Selway, Harry Romero, Victor Ruiz from Brazil, Weber from Brazil, Tupol from Germany, and Drunken Kong from Japan.
Wow.
So yeah, lots of artists and, you know, just something different.
And do you think that it's easier to produce a track yourself or with other people? What are the inconvenience and positive things?
I really like both. I mean, the good thing about collaborating with other people is that you get instant feedback. You know, they will tell you right away, oh, this is good or this is not good.
Okay.
Whereas when you're by yourself, you have to be confident doing what you do. So, you know, it's nice to collaborate with people as long as they are also competent and bring things to the table. And that is proper teamwork.
So you're going to play some tracks of this album today?
I think so. Let's see what happens.
So you have been a DJ, you say, for 20 years, but also you are the owner of Tronic label. So how did you decide to publish a new label?
Well, kind of just like DJing, I started it as a hobby and it just became something big organically. And in the last 5 years, the label has grown a lot. We released a lot of albums. And right now it's the second biggest selling techno label in the world.
Yeah.
So I'm very happy about that. And I have a very good team as well. I have a very good label manager, a very good PR agent. These days, teamwork is very, very important if you want to be successful.
And how it changed nowadays to do a label, to make a label, could be easier than in the past. So how did you...
It's easy to have a label now, but it's not easy to have a professional label.
Of course.
There's a big difference between releasing a single and not doing anything, or releasing a single and being totally organized, that the track is promoted all over social media, that all the big DJs have the tracks and play the tracks. It's a lot of work and a lot of effort. But at the end of the day, I love making music. I'm very happy with Tronic, my label, and again, the team that I work with.
Yeah, but I think that when 20 years ago it was more difficult to publish a new label, because nowadays with internet you can contact to...
You're very right. I mean, back in the days there was no MP3. There was no digital.
Because you start with cassette, then you play CDs, then Tractor games, then...
You're forgetting vinyl. I think that's the most important one. I mean, I did vinyl for a long time.
You missed it?
I still release vinyl on Tronic, but I don't play with vinyl because, I travel every weekend all around the world, and I really do not miss carrying, 40 kilograms in 2 flight cases. Of records wherever I go, so I don't miss it, no.
No.
No, also with digital, you can bring so much more music with you. So you can play the right music at the right moment. Whereas if you just have a record case, you might have 100, 200 records. What if those records don't fit perfectly in that moment? I think me becoming a digital DJ has made me a better DJ.
Well, you, Christian, was last week in ADE.
Yes, ADE, yes.
ADE. What could you tell us about it?
Well, ADE is Amsterdam Dance Event. It's in Holland, and it's the gathering of the whole music industry once a year. For 5 days, you do lots of meetings. You meet with friends, you meet with colleagues, you do business meetings, and you do lots of parties as well. There's pretty much every house and techno DJ was there, and it's just good fun because all of my friends also do their own parties and we party together. For example, I went to Adam Bayer's Drum Code party, and I went to the Afterlife party. It's just a lot of fun. It's also very heavy because I came back yesterday. I was there for 5 days. 5 days of partying and meetings. It's exhausting.
Yeah, but I think I'm sure it will be amazing, great.
No, I suggest
great meetings.
If you're serious about the music industry, I would highly suggest for you to go to Amsterdam next year. It's a very cool learning experience going there.
Well, I would like to go.
You should go.
I hope. Okay, Christian, so would you like to tell us something else about what you are going to share with us in this set? And where are you going to play next dates where people can follow you?
Well, in this set, I'm just going to play the music that I usually play, and hope you like it. Where am I going to play? Oof, good question. I never know. I know next weekend I'm playing in London. I'm playing in London at a club called Egg.
Egg
which
Club.
Which is a really, really cool club for Halloween. That should be a lot of fun. And before the end of the year, I go to North America. And New Year's Eve, I'm playing in Argentina. And January 1st, I play in Chile.
Wow. Speaking about the USA, you was living in the USA.
Yes. I lived in New York for around 10 years. And it was amazing because I moved to New York. I was young. I was like in my early 20s. And I just started becoming an international DJ. So I was, I was making lots of money, having lots of fun. And just being young and stupid,
But you learn everything about electronic music in the USA, then in Germany, and no, then...
It's a very good point. I mean, living in New York, I got exposed to a lot of house music and to all of the house legends, Kenny Dope, Louis Vega, Junior Vasquez,
But you are speaking, the most of them are house artists. You are now one of the best techno exponents of the world.
I'm a techno artist, but I love house as well, and I think without house music, techno would be very different today. So house music has definitely influenced techno a lot. I mean, if you look at the biggest techno DJs or producers in the world, they're all heavily influenced by house music.
Nice to listen to it. Well, so 15 minutes to arrive at the 6 p.m. So we're going to do this set. I hope you enjoy, and thank you very much for coming, Christian.
And thanks for having me, and I can't wait to start at 6 p.m.
Aquí, pues ya sabéis, desde las 6 de la tarde en Vicio Radio no os podéis perder la sesión en directo de Christian Smith. uno de los grandes del techno. Además, hablando de pinchando nuevos temas de su último álbum, Synergy. No os lo perdáis aquí en Vicio Radio de 6 a 7. En unos minutos arrancará la sesión en directo de Christian Smith aquí en Vicio Radio, que podéis seguir a través de video streaming desde el Facebook de Vicio Radio y Vicios Magazine. Por cierto, recordar el programa especial que tenéis de Christian Smith, de su sello Tronic, que se emite todos los lunes aquí en esta casa en Vicio Radio desde la 1 hasta las 2 de la madrugada. 5 y 52 minutos. Recordar a toda la gente que nos está escuchando y también que nos está viendo a través de Facebook Live desde Vicios Radio, Vicios Magazine, que hacemos un pequeño corte, unos minutitos para publicidad y que regresamos desde las 6 de la tarde con la sesión en directo de Christian Smith, que pinchará además esos tracks de su nuevo álbum Synergy, que no te puedes perder. Así que desde las 6, todo el mundo conectado escuchando Vicios Radio y también a través de Facebook. No os lo perdáis.
DJs, music, clubbing, interviews, Pata Negra every Tuesday from 6 till 7 p.m. presented by Rosanna Nunn.
There comes a time when the rat has to ask himself, what's in it for the rat?
transcribe the music into the language that all minds agree. Use this language of freedom.
Seguimos en directo aquí en Vicio Radio con la sesión de Christian Smith. Continuamos unos minutos hasta el final del programa. Recuerda que también lo podéis ver ahora mismo en directo a través del Facebook Live de Vicio Radio y Vicios Magazine. Christian Smith aquí en Vicio Radio, no te lo pierdas. We'll be right back.
You're listening to Pata Negra Radio Show.
Minutos nada más el set de Christian Smith, que además puedes ver de nuevo, puedes escuchar y puedes ver de nuevo a través de Facebook, del video streaming que hemos realizado desde el Facebook de Vicious Radio, Vicious Magazine. Esta ha sido la sesión de Christian Smith. Volvemos el próximo martes con más música, más artistas, más sesiones. Buena semana y buen fin de semana.